Good morning, Suicindo team, which includes all the world. So, good morning, world. Today's conversation is titled Does Having a Doubt Gives You a Pleasure? Yes, and one small note, this is dedicated to Denise, one of the core members of Suicindo. Thank you, Denise. Most of our daily existence is based on having doubts. What we're going to do? Are we going to make it? Are your family members going to make it? How's your life? Is it going to be successful? When you think about success, you're having doubts. When you think about the failure, you're having doubts. When you think what you're going to cook for the dinner or for lunch, you're having doubts. So, when you unwrap another layer of why people do this, because it seems this gives them certain pleasurable feeling of self-hate, self-hurting. Being victim. I want you to deep down recognize this is not who you are. You're not a being who has to have so many doubts. But continuing on a every minute basis, an hourly basis, on daily basis. So imagine this goes through a life of 50, 60, 100 years. Like, you can't wait to die because your energy is completely drained. This is what doubt in the a human energetic bodies is doing. It's actually draining you out. Church, religion, any kind, brings nothing else but doubt, fear in God. Having fear is the same as having doubt. So how to start getting rid of this doubtful me? Or doubt for you. It's always the same story. First, you recognize. Recognize why you are upset. You recognize why you're not trusting in yourself. Recognize why you allowing yourself to be self-mutilated. Like, you're not much different than Opus Dei self-hurting beings who are wiping themselves with whips and with a metal claws and whatever. You're just doing it emotionally, mentally, and basically energetically every time you have a doubt. So, I think that should be it for now, because every single one of you have to start look within yourself. Who am I to tell you anything? Maybe you're not. Maybe you're completely perfect. Just do whatever gives you a pleasure. Yeah, that's a tricky one. So, look what creates love in you. Not pleasure, but love. Pleasure is, in the terms of energies, something ancient, something old, something overtalked. But we are here to discover how we can transmute this being doubtful, pleasureful, greedy me into something a bit bigger, a bit opener, much more opener than you are now. I really don't want to any of you take these as a preachings. It's just me blabbing. I'm just blabbing and blabbing. But I know what I'm doing, so I'm blabbing. And I have no doubts about it. But beside that, I still have fun. I don't expect anything from you. And I still have fun. So how this is possible in this kind of materialistic way of life that we are right now? Having fun, not expecting anything in return for whatever I'm doing. Because I receive so much that it's indescribable, and I actually wish for you to feel it. You feel me as the one who receives. You're asking from whom? Or from who? From them. Mother, Father, God, Universal Source, Force. This is here for us just to give. And they are teaching us all this millions of years, thousands of lifetimes. They are teaching us not to have doubt in yourself. Because when you doubt yourself, you doubt in God. When you doubt in your friend, in your lover, in your family member, you doubt in God. When you doubt in God, you're assuming you're not worthy. When you're not worthy, what you're going to receive tomorrow? You will receive a bunch of not worthiness. Go and listen one before. How to create your own abundance. To cause your own abundance. It's all very related what I'm talking. I'm just giving these funny subjects to titles to at least get you enticed to start hearing what I'm saying. You don't have to obey in any way anything I say, but you just hear me, please. Thank you very much, Denise, for allowing me to talk about this. I love you. Ciao.